Previously, we have seen the model of the putative exon with a weighted interval in the genome sequence. Now we will see through a diagram that how we can calculate the putative exon by making use of the weighted intervals. So we will find the putative exon by making use of the weighted intervals in this diagram. So in this diagram, we can see there are 5 weighted intervals. The first weighted interval is starting from 2 and ends up at 3. But it has a weight interval of 3 also. So we will write this as 2, 3 and 3. The second weight interval is 4, 8, 6. So it means it will starting from 4 and it's end up at 8 and it has a weight of 6. So we will write it here as 4, 8, 6. The third is starting from 9, it's end up at 10 and weight of 1. So we'll write 9, 10, 1. And the last is 11 and it's end up at 15. So this one and has a weight of 7. So we'll write 11, 15, 7. And the last one is 16, starting from 16 and ending at 18 and has a weight of 4. So we will write 16, 18, 4. So we'll write in the graphic display also we can write and we can say that this is the first 2, 3, 3 starting from 2 ending up at 3. So we will write at 2, 3 and a weight of 3. Second is starting from 4. And we can see that's the bold lines, they represent these weighted intervals. And this is the second one, starting from 4 and ending at 8. Third one is starting from 9 and ending up at 10 with a weight of only 1. Similarly, starting from fourth one is starting from 11 and it's end up at 15. And the last one is starting from 16 and it end up at 18. So by using these, we can say that there is an optimal solution to the exon changing problem. And the array of the bottom shows that the values, they start from S1 to S2 and it goes up to S2N. Generated by the exon changing algorithm. In the last slide, we have seen that the graphic representation through the diagram, there were many possibilities to identify the codons and the exons. So the exons, we have seen that there were very many possibilities of the exons, and we have seen many overlapping exons as well. But in the bold, we have seen that only those exons were selected that were not overlapping. So because we know that exons, they do not overlap. So by using this approach, we can only select those exons that were not overlapping and they were called as putative exons.